Dollar dollar bill, come get her. Even your man know Nikki's do it better. I know you don't like me.
Hey everyone, we just received our new safety cow, and just like you guys, we were wondering if it had the same effect as our kitty. So we tested it out on the apple, and it pretty much had the same effect. What other fruits would you guys like to see?
So this boyfriend ordered his girl a necklace that says my person and another one that says te amo, and that's not even half of it. He got her the set that sticks together, this dragon couple set that represented strength in a relationship, a heart bracelet to represent his love, this butterfly necklace, and butterfly promise ring. And he just emailed me and said that she cheated.
When I first launched my business, even some of my closest friends had nothing to say. They didn't necessarily support me, meaning like or share my content or even ask me how it was going with the brand. They just kind of, you know, stayed silent. And at first I took offense to it, but then I quickly realized it is normal human behavior. They had never seen someone try to accomplish something so ambitious. It was just easy.
My friends and family keep asking me how my small business is doing, which is awesome. And I keep saying something along the lines of, the response has been overwhelming. And I think when people hear that, they think it means that I'm getting a million orders. But when I say that the response has been overwhelming, what I mean is that the support has been overwhelming. The love has been overwhelming. The idea that someone wants to buy something that I made with my hands is overwhelming. And I think watching myself grow in confidence is pretty overwhelming too.
In the early days of Fizzy Soaps, I wasn't making any sales, and this caused me to make my soaps very cheap so people would buy. I would work hours to make a beautiful bar soap and charge low prices because without this, no one would buy my soap. And it was hard because I knew my work was worth more, but no one else thought so, and it was the only way I could make a sale. Now I know that this was a mistake, but back then it seemed like a reasonable thing to do. My advice to other small creators is to charge what you believe your product is worth, and if other people don't think so, then that's okay. Those who value your work will not cut you short.
I'm gonna test stuff on my keychain just to show you guys.
So we'll test the hammer first.
We'll test this first.
This is just a lash case from my unsuccessful lash business. So you use this part to crack it. Okay, so it cracked in half.
So I'm at the junkyard now and we're gonna test it on this thing.
We did this twice, but we didn't record it both times. So yeah, sorry.
So I cut it, but my boyfriend wasn't recording, so we're gonna do it again.
There is a lady watching this clip, but we cracked it once and then the second time the whole window broke off. Okay, bye.
Jennifer ordered her name Butterfly Joker and leave me a message. Even though Jennifer is not a pretty name, I want it to look pretty. So I make her this card to let her know that Jennifer is a very pretty name and this necklace makes her even prettier. Hi Jennifer, do you know that your name means white fairy? And putting it on the butterfly choker, it has a beautiful meaning. A white fairy who bring change, hope, rebirth, and renewal. I believe that every name has its own meaning and a beautiful story to be told. What does your name mean?
make some...
I officially launched... ...of my friend trying to sell me to a pedophile in high school. So originally, my dad thought that I was in on this and me and Elizabeth were like meeting up with older guys and he was really mad at me. I had no idea what was going on, but at first he didn't believe me. So I texted Elizabeth, I asked her what was going on and where her boyfriend was, and she just kept telling me that I wasn't supposed to be here with my dad, I was supposed to have walked, and my dad should go home. At this point, my dad thought I was lying to him, and he grounded me, and he took me home straight away. I didn't even get out of the car. So I spent the whole night texting Elizabeth, and I told her that I saw her with the two 30-year-old men, and that I didn't know who they were, and that my dad took me home because I got grounded. And she was really mad at me, and I couldn't understand why she was so mad at me, because, you know, I was 14, so I didn't really understand anything. And finally, she just told me that we would talk about it on Monday at school, like for part three.
I work as an assistant for a really big fashion company. I had a defective wedding dress, and my boss asked if I knew anyone we could give it to. My best friend recently got engaged, so it was perfect. When she posted on Instagram to thank me and my boss, my family caught wind of it, and that's when the influx of calls came. I do not have a good relationship with my family. My parents kicked me out when I was 16 after I came out to them, and my sister wasn't much better. They demanded to know why I gave the dress to my friend and not to my sister. I didn't even know she was engaged. They suggested I try to take it back from my friend, as family should always come first. My sister even tried to call my boss to complain. I just got off the phone with my mom, and this is how the conversation went. She says my sister is very upset about the dress, and I told her she needs to get over it. My mom says I can make it up to them by giving her another dress. I posted one last night on my Instagram. It's a $12,000 dress, and that's the one my sister wants. And I told her, you expect me to give you a $12,000 dress when you kicked me out when I was 16? My mom says, that was a long time ago, and we're talking about your sister, not me. When I refuse to give the dress, my mom says the least I can do is help her buy one. At this point, I hang up, and I've been avoiding them since then.
My sister wanted me to make a special candy container for her, so I started by adding some of our original chamoy to the bottom of the container. Then I got some of our chamoy gushers and sour belts. This is the sour rainbow belts, and I started wrapping the chamoy gusher in the belt. I did this over and over until I filled the bottom of the container. And I did use different sour belts. This is the watermelon sour belt, and I also used the strawberry sour belt. It took about 10 rolls to cover the bottom of the container, and it took a while because every single one I wrapped a gusher. The reason I added the chamoy at the bottom is because I thought it would just give it that extra touch to every single roll. Once I filled up the bottom, I drizzled some of our original chamoy and added some more sour belts. And here I did add the blue raspberry. And I did put some extra chamoy gushers at the top, and this is the final look.
I've gotten a lot of requests for a slower tutorial of the bubbles painting, so here it is. I start by painting the background black, and then I grab different size cups, whichever ones you have, and then I paint those cups white and I press them onto the canvas, and repeating that with the other size cups. And you just want to make sure they're evenly spaced, so it should look something like this when you're done. Then I'm going to start my color palette, which looks something like this, and I start painting the bubbles. You're going to want to paint around the edges and on opposite sides of the bubbles, making it kind of random, just whatever looks right. And then at the end, it's going to look something like this. Then you're going to want to grab a lighter color, like light pink, light blue, and light green. And you're going to do highlights right where the colors are. After that, you're going to go in with a fine brush and paint stars throughout the bubbles, add some dots, and there's your finished product.